Each of you, quit judging everybody, because you can't get on the inside. You have no idea what people are going through on the inside. And some people are struggling with some stuff that you wouldn't imagine. And the little stuff that you have imagined, that's little stuff. Stuff they're really struggling with, you couldn't imagine. So you don't do the judgment thing because you don't know. See, God is like this. Now, y'all didn't see me steal this eraser. But God saw me steal the eraser. He don't do the deed. He do the purpose for the deed. Because some things you can do and never be forgiven for. Because it's purpose. It's what was in your heart, what was in your mind when you went there. And there are some things you can do and have, no matter how bad they are, and get forgiven. This is the reason that Saul couldn't get forgiven, but David could. I think David was worse than Saul. That's my opinion.
Me too.
Because when I look at the list, okay, so Saul did an animal sacrifice. Them poor animals, he killed them. They was going to die anyway. You know? Saul didn't kill Agag, the king. So what? David done killed Uriah, one of God's servants. Took his woman. Pumped up with baby. And then, not only did he kill him, but he sent the man the bullet to be shot with. Take this to Joab. And the note says, soon as the battle is heavy, leave Uriah. He took his, you see what I'm saying? David sat there and plotted and planned. I'm telling you what the scriptures show me. I don't really find no plotting and planning in Saul. Saul was just doing stuff. David methodically plotted that. When he sent for Uriah, told him to go home, Uriah wouldn't go. Wouldn't go. Uriah said, man, I ain't going out there. And the servants of the Lord is out in the open field, and I'm going to go home to a cushiony bed. I ain't going. I'm going to sleep on the door of the palace. Noble. Righteous. Now, I think killing him would be more weighty than anything Saul did. That's my opinion. Now, y'all know I ain't God. Please understand that. If you want to know whether I'm God or not, I got to pay rent this month. God don't pay rent. See, so when you do an analytical analysis of the two lives, there's no way that what Saul did could come close to the stuff David did. But yet God forgave David and kept the charge on Saul. So there must have been something internal that you cannot evaluate from seeing the deeds that God evaluated and charged one and release the other. And that's why you don't want to do, you know, judging somebody and determining who going to be saved and who ain't. You don't want to do that. Even though they might be, you know, the devil's scared of them. You know, he's scared they're going to come in there. We talk about tearing his kingdom down. They're going to come in and build it up. He's scared of that. You still don't want to say they can't get in. Because once you say they can't get in, then you have become the judge.
Yes.
There's only one judge.
That's
right. So that's why I'm saying that. And I'll get you one second, my friend. I'll get you one second. That's why I'm saying, I just believe that if you mean to do right and be right, God will cause you to do right and be right.
That's right.
I just thoroughly believe that. Now, I'm just a believer of that. Now, that don't mean you jump up and you just do what you want to do, thinking you all of that now. Don't try to get bad with God. Yes, sir. What's your question?
Is there sin for Lucifer that he thought
of? No.
Then what tempted him? If temptation, by the way, I think temptation is sin. If there wasn't sin, how was there temptation? What tempted Lucifer?
Give it to you in one word, my friend. Yes, sir. Pride.
Jesus.
He wanted to be the head of God. That's what got him. This is the same thing that's killing folk in the church too. Yeah. And that's what I'm when Minister Floyd said, when she said, she wasn't talking about the person that had pride. they just thought it was such a damnable act, man, that nobody should ever have to know this, you know, and that kind of thing. And they feel so bad about it. You know, a good example of that would be somebody coming to church, saint coming to church, get the Holy Ghost, and they've killed 10 people. You know, because they did contracts. They put a hit on it. They took a hit for 10 people and killed them. I kind of don't want to tell people that. You know what I'm saying? That would be one of those things that'd be like, I don't know, you know. You know. Now, I still believe that at a point in time they may, you know, may say that. But I think it's going to be a while before they get that one out. That's just me. And they may come in the door like, look, man, I killed 10 people in testimony service. And, you know, and I was a hit man and blah, blah, blah. You know, because they got to remember, you know, you need to know this, there is no, you know, statute of limitation for murder. So when they get on there and say that, Sister Jackie put them on YouTube. And the FBI come kick my door in there before I'm bringing right to your I am. So, but I'm saying that could be one of those things, because there are people that will have been engaged in those activities, and you don't have to try to pry everything out of everybody. Let God do it.
Yes.
God can get stuff out better than you. Yes, ma'am.
So, if pride was the reason of the temptation,
No, that was the reason for his fall. Now, if you want to use what tempted him to become like that, power was the temptation. He felt that he could be more powerful than God. It was about power. Well, pride is usually something that the fella had because they believe they got that. since I'm on top, can't nobody bother me. You know, do what I want. But this was the driving force. He wanted the power, the total power above God, and his pride took him in. That's what caused him to fail. You will never have pride if you always keep him
humble.
Yep. Stay humble. You don't have to fight for pride. Always, always recognize your position and how to behave properly in that position. Because it's just a position. This is, I'm a pastor. It's just a position. I ain't got no authority. I ain't got no more God than anybody in here. Just because I'm the pastor. He may use me more often, but I still don't have no more.
So when they say no sin is greater than the other, in my opinion, why isn't pride a great, like, you know what I'm saying? One of the top sins, like blasphemy. You know, we can't blaspheme to God.
It's pride is not a top sin. When you have pride, you just gonna commit more sins. Pride causes you to do more stuff than if you was a humble sinner. Yes, sir. He does not forgive blasphemy. That's the other thing. When you blaspheme the Holy Ghost, you cannot be forgiven. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, we trust in God, lay that out, like, clean for me, like...
Lay what out, clean for you?
Exactly. The word.
Blasphemy?
Yeah. Exactly.
What does it mean to blaspheme?
Yeah.
When you blaspheme, you basically... It's... I can't give you a clear definition because it does involve pride. But typically, to blaspheme the Holy Ghost is to speak against the Holy Ghost's ability to save. To tell people, you don't need no Holy Ghost. That ain't nothing. It won't help you. you speak against the power of the Holy Ghost. Now again, understand what I'm saying. Because I believe God to be a wise God. There's probably individuals that's sitting in here that say, you know, man, I don't think the Holy Ghost can help me. You know, but God is smart. He know you don't really mean that. So he don't charge you with it. This is the thing about God. God only charge you with what he know you mean, you understand, and you're fully aware. See, you walk by me and say, I don't believe in the Holy Ghost. Blasphemy, you demon, to hell with you. You know, that's how I do it. But God be like, nah, they crazy. Now, I want a conference call with God because I want to know how come he didn't support my acknowledgement of your blasphemy. Now, so God said, well, you know, you ain't humble yet. So you got pride. So then I'll be the one messed up. But basically, in the basic format, that's what blasphemy would be. Where you would speak against God's ability to save, sanctify, and make holy.